moving forward, after the Civil War ended and the great migration of African Americans moving north, were there any cities that welcomed African Americans, and what pastimes and sports flourished in those cities due to the number of African Americans arriving in those cities?
Yeah, I wouldn't say welcome necessarily, but certainly a number of many African Americans fled the South and found their way up north to various cities. You know, they found their way to Cleveland, Ohio, Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, New York City, Detroit, Michigan, and would settle in those large metropolitan areas. There were jobs. They found jobs in those places and set up their families and were able to earn livings, not always necessarily great living experiences, but were able to settle down, and they established their own churches, for example. They set up their own, in some cases, schools. They set up their own newspapers, very important newspapers that were integral to the African American community. And they established their own sporting programs. One of the things they did was they established their own athletic clubs, for example. They established their own baseball teams. They established their own football teams, their own basketball teams, once basketball was founded in the late 1890s. So they set up their own sporting organizations. There are examples, however, of African American athletes that were able to compete against white athletes. There's evidence of that. So it wasn't just all black parallel sporting institutions that flourished and they participated just among themselves, but in some instances they were able to compete against white athletes and also able to compete against white teams.
Were any sports more accepting or open to African Americans than others?
Seemingly, basketball was a sport where they found opportunities that they might, African Americans might not have found in baseball, for example. Two classic examples, the two most famous all-black basketball teams were the New York Renaissance Five and the Harlem Globetrotters. And both the New York Renaissance Five and Harlem Globetrotters, that actually had their origins during the decade of the 1920s. So I'm moving up in time a bit. Both of those teams barnstormed. Both of those teams traveled not just through the North, but they also on occasion would travel through the South and compete against, in some cases, compete against white teams. One team they competed against was the famous Philadelphia Spas, an all-Jewish basketball club, for instance. So basketball was, now, they had to deal with Southern culture and Southern life and Southern racial policies. They competed against white teams, but had to stay in black hotels. They competed against white teams, but had to eat in separate restaurants, separate restroom facilities, separate fountains, drinking fountains. So the racial mores and the racial realities of the South was staring them straight in the face, but and that was difficult to overcome, but nonetheless, in some cases, in some instances, we know they competed against white teams.